Hi everyone. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Sorry, I'm a bit nervous. Okay. I am here for my friend family, Priya and Nadesh, from Bilo. I lived in Bilo for 2 years and I know them for nearly 3 years. I feel very emotional, sorry, because it's when I see these people come here to help us, it's really make me very emotional. And yeah, I'm here for the four Sri Lankan people, four Tamils that being recently deporting to Sri Lanka. And what happened is we have been scared and hiding in forest, and I came by boat here. So I know what felt like when you there's a bomb and things like that, you run in the forest and holding your parents' hand, and when people sometimes disappear suddenly and nobody even noticed. And when people died, shot by gun it, and you just have to pass through and you don't have freedom to ask what happened to them. And if you ask, and you will disappear next day or even in the night. So in 2009, the war was in, like, people think that they then ending officially. But it happened, still happening, still people disappearing, still people who were related to LTT and still having trouble. And every year we remembering the day 18 of May, that our memorable day of the end of war. So we were, there's people like hold the handles and light the candles for the lost the mother or father, brother or sister in eastern north side. And then once it's happening in eastern north side, and once in a part of south side in Sri Lanka, there were fireworks and partying and dancing on the street because they're celebrating that day. Because they are happy, while we are remembering this day that we lost our relations. So what on earth country to celebrate the own country people dead that day? But how can I celebrate that day? So how do we live in that country peacefully and safely? And I saw some people on the Facebook or on the comments, and they were saying like, Tamils are safe now in Sri Lanka and you can return. There's war finished and you can go home now. And I was like, people never understand what's happening in back at there. So I just wanted to say, stop deporting Tamil people to Sri Lanka and stop deporting this beautiful family. I'm every day talking to Priya and Nadis over the phone, and I'm talking to their girls because they were so upset. They locked up in 5 months in there. I have a daughter, she's 1 year old, like Taranika, same as her. And like my daughter crawling over there and exploring things, and these kids are locked up there and they didn't do anything all day. They just sit and play with their mom and dad. Kids need to have freedom. Kids need to be explore the world. So please let them home. Please bring them home. Thank you.